Am Max Payne.
So I finally played Max Payne 2, and it was alright. It was pretty good, I guess. Yeah, I'm just fucking with y'all. Max Payne 2 is a perfect sequel in every regard.
Oh, detective, I've got something for you.
Cover me!
It improves on the first game's gameplay, graphics, voice acting, story, everything. So it still feels similar to the first one, but unique at the same time. Max Payne 2 was once again written by the extremely talented Sam Lake, and was developed once again by the same team at Remedy. This time the game was published by Rockstar Games, however, who planned to buy the rights to the franchise after the release of Max Payne 2. So rather unfortunately, Max Payne 2, The Fall of Max Payne, was sort of Remedy's goodbye to the iconic character that they had created. So needless to say, the whole team put their all into this sequel. Everyone's hearts were in it, and you can tell just from playing the game. Max Payne 2 follows Max Payne, once again, obviously, who decides in a peak of his depression to return to the NYPD. During a distress call, Max reunites with his soon-to-be-dead former lover, Mona Sachs, a character featured briefly in the first game who will become a key figure in this one. And usually something like that probably wouldn't work, but it does extremely well in this case. I think Max Payne 2 might be the best love story in gaming. Well, the second best, anyway. In fact, just about all this story works for me. It feels like a direct sequel to the first one, but it also feels like its own thing entirely. It's no Die Hard 2 is basically what I'm saying. Also, they should make a Die Hard game that controls like Max Payne. I'm being dead fucking serious. Max Payne 2 opens 2 years after the last game on a super rainy night in New York City. Max Payne gets a call about a giant ass gang war that's happening, and he decides to intervene. During the chaos, Max encounters his soon-to-be-dead Mona Sachs, and the plot kicks into hyperdrive from there. It follows Max once again as he fights his way through hell and his own mind. The game shines a light on Max's bad deeds and chooses to question his morality. Mona Sachs is good for him in the sense that she gives him a reason to fight, she gives him a purpose again, but she also brings out the worst side of him, the side that does really bad things, the side of Max that likes to hurt people. The first game painted Max in a really positive light. It tried to make him seem really justified in his actions. But this game does the complete opposite, and instead blurs the line completely and lets the player decide if they personally empathize with Max or not. This game shows him at possibly his lowest, and he has to fight his way through his thickest trauma yet, and the misdeeds that he's committed over the years. And once again, if that doesn't sound like a good setup to you, I don't know what to tell you.
Gunshots made me deaf to the sirens. But they couldn't drown the sobs of my dead wife.
Mona. Max Payne 2 completely improves on the first game's structure. It's endlessly fun and addictive. It's so smooth and so fluent that you can get lost in it for hours. Recently, I decided to mix Joey Badass with this game, and I just gotta fucking show you.
Make sure my shit sound tight. I never knew the world could be this mad. Only vision I had of sex was calling me bad. And I never knew the world could be this cold. Only time a nigga died, he was playing the role. But now niggas get their soul stole so often. The only thing they offer demons is awakening a coffin. From NY to Compton, down to Austin, she said that orphans morphed to abortions without precaution.
Max Payne 2 somehow managed to make bullet time even more fun. The slow-mo feels a lot smoother and much more in your favor. Max seems to move a lot quicker than he used to. And that's because as you kill more and more dudes in bullet time, he gets progressively faster and faster. It's sick as fuck. It allows for the mechanic to feel a lot more useful this time around. Of course, diving is fun as ever. This mechanic has always been perfect, and there really isn't much you could or even should change about it. This game also introduces a crowd takedown, which can be activated during bullet time. It shows Max spinning around and unloading on all enemies like he's in the goddamn Matrix. Movement in general feels a lot better. Max is super easy to control in this game, and his animations are a lot less stiff. I also love how he just has this little bounce when he runs.
Hut, hut, hut.
The accuracy of your weapons is vastly improved, making your crosshair actually trustworthy for once. The weapons pack such a punch and you can feel the impact, it's really satisfying. Not to mention the fact that the enemies just ragdoll when they die now and it never gets old. The arsenal is still fantastic. We see the return of classics such as the engrams, dual pistol, shotgun, grenade launcher, all that shit. But we also see the introduction of new weapons such as the MP5 or the AK-47. The game also has you play as Mona Sachs sometimes, which is the only time you play as someone else besides Max for the entire trilogy. And usually I'd be annoyed with something like this, but Mona's just as fun to play as, so it's fine. The level design in this game is splendid. It ditches the narrow corridors and staircases that the first game used too often in favor of these much larger open open areas that are easy to fight in and a lot more fun. The game also has great variety in its locations like the first one. You get everything from hospitals filled with SWAT-looking ass dudes to the empty ass decaying buildings. We also see the return of the trippy nightmare segments, which I just love. The game's atmosphere also plays a great factor in this game's fun-ass levels. They completely achieved a dark and grainy noir look they were going for. New York goes from a snow-covered wonderland to a dark and wet hellhole, and it's amazingly handled. The first game's art style was instantly iconic, and I'm glad to see it makes a return here. I'll literally never get tired of hearing Max narrate everything that's happening. Also, we get great attention to detail in the world, which makes it feel even more alive. Hey look, it's Dick Justice.
No, no, no! Oh, don't go! Oh God, Jared, baby! No!
This game's story is also a lot more than the first one was. It really questions Max as a person. It pushes him to his lowest points over and over again. But for some reason, he keeps coming back. For some reason, he always gets back up. A lot of the criminals in New York would probably just assume he has a bloodlust and he's just too stubborn to die. But it's definitely a lot deeper than that. Max has a heart. It might not seem like it, hell, he might even seem downright evil sometimes, but he cares. He's always fighting for something or someone who matters to him. Justified or not, Max knows exactly who he is and exactly what he's doing. He doesn't have a bloodlust, even though killing comes really easy for him. He just does what he feels is necessary, and the players might not always agree with him, and that's fine. That's the point of this entire game. Max does some heinous shit, but we can somewhat understand him. We can empathize with him, as we know what he's been through and what he's currently going through. Mona Sachs is important because she gives him a reason to fight again, not just to fight evil, but to fight the battles that are raging in his mind, to overcome his grief, addiction, and depression, to once again, love.
This is love, when someone, no matter what the cost, shows you there is hope, a choice, that you can put down your gun.
I love Max Payne 2. It might honestly be one of my favorite games of all time, and it's easily my favorite of the Max Payne trilogy. It deeply impacted me when I first played it just recently, and I'm honestly shocked at how much I loved it. I said in my first video that I didn't think I'd be able to love it as much as the first one. Well, someone might as well just serve up the crow because it's fucking dinner time, I guess. But I think Max Payne 2 improves on everything from the first game and is somehow a better experience. But unfortunately, it did underperform compared to the first game. Remedy has never released the exact amount, but it's said that it did not sell nearly as good as the first one. Which just really sucks because it's a great sequel. It's the definition of how you do one right. And a lot of people just haven't played it. You'll see a lot more love for the first and even third game than you will the second game, and that's kind of depressing. That's why I wanted to make this video so bad. I love Max Payne 2, and I hope with this video I was maybe able to convince you that it is a perfect sequel.
I had a dream of my wife. She was dead, but it was all right.